Thanks a lot. Welcome everybody. Today is the final day of class in the class Neuroeconomics at the Erasmus School of Economics. My students are going to present their final presentation on neuroscience and neuroeconomics. And I'm very curious what they have to say because this has been a challenging and interesting class. Thanks a lot. Good luck.
Our presentation is about selective attention today. This is David, Erik and Warsha, and my name is Joyce. And first we will show you a video that will help us explain the concept to you. And for the ones that already know the video, please let the other ones enjoy it.
Clearly, somebody in this room murdered Lord Smythe, who, at precisely 3:34 this afternoon, was brutally bludgeoned to death with a blunt instrument. I want each of you to tell me your whereabouts at precisely the time that this dastardly deed took place.
I was polishing the brass in the master bedroom.
I was buttering his lordship's scones below stairs, sir.
Why, I was planting my petunias in the potting shed.
Constable, arrest Lady Smythe.
But how did you know?
Madam, as any horticulturist will tell you, one does not plant petunias until May is out. Take her away.
Sorry, madam.
It's just a matter of observation. The real question is, how observant were you?
Okay, so as you know, our presentation is about selective attention, and we were wondering if you noticed anything strange in this video. Okay, we'll save this till the end, and then you'll see more of it. But for now, we'll go through with the presentation.
So, Gasol and Noel say that selective attention is goal-directed focus on one aspect of the environment while ignoring other irrelevant aspects. So basically, when you focus on one aspect, you miss out on a lot of other things, as maybe you've seen in the video. And yeah, what happens in the brain is that it is constantly bombarded with different stimuli, and this is processed in the sensory cortices, and especially the neuromodulators dopamine and acetylcholine are in control of the neuroactivity when this happens.
Okay, so now we've basically tried to explain how it works in the brain, but selective attention is not completely understood by experts yet, so we wanted to focus as well on the social implications. And I wanted to start with conditioning. As Joyce said, in any situation you see a lot of different stimuli. For example, I see different colors on every seat, I see you, different faces, see a camera. But my main goal is to transfer my information to you. So the importance of this is when you focus your attention on just the relevant stimuli, you get better and more predictive conditioning. But if you have a problem in the selective attention, it means that you get a lot of stimuli. But if you also have a problem with your impulse control, you react on every stimuli you get. So that's a bit the problem with ADHD.
There are also people with autism spectrum disorder. These people are unimpaired to understand social cues or and responding to them. Their selective attention is not on the main things where most people will focus on, but they will focus more on the background. So if people with ASD will watch the movie Whodunit, he won't listen to the story the man is telling, but he will focus a lot more on the background and the things who are changing. So the five things or the four things we could list now. If someone with ASD would sit here, he would list a lot more of things.
I want to tell something about our case study we did. And that is, our question was, are selective attention skills trainable? To study whether these skills can be trained in selective attention, we did research. We studied two researches done. One involved an action gameplay, and the other a mind-body training with meditators.
So I think for this case, the conclusion was that through certain ways. For example, playing video games, children will teach themselves to focus more on one aspect and not get distracted by everything that surrounds them. So if we know we have a little time, so we still want to show the last part of the video you saw.
Clearly, somebody in this room murdered Lord Smythe, who, at precisely 3:34 this afternoon, was brutally bludgeoned to death with a blunt instrument. I want each of you to tell me your whereabouts at precisely the time that this dastardly deed took place.
I was polishing the brass in the master bedroom.
I was buttering his lordship's scones below stairs, sir.
But I was planting my petunias in the potting shed.
Constable, arrest Lady Smythe.
Okay, so that concludes. There's obviously a lot of more stimuli which you don't respond to. Thank you.